Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the RaidCall EMS One Fall Season. Group Stage A is what we are doing right now, where we now have our team to possibly be eliminated. If 4FC are incapable of winning this game right now, they will be the first team out of the Group Stages series. And, of course, the winner will fight up tomorrow evening at 20 CEST up against Fnatic to see if they can progress themselves through to get themselves into that LAN final situation. Well, let's see who it's going to be as we jump ourselves over into our draft and we'll see everything unfold before our very eyes with one over on the Dire side. Banning out the Wisp and the Batrider, we see LOA as well as Visage taken out. Kind of happy to see that LOA being removed out. He is a bloody powerful hero. At the same time, though, we do see Naga back here again. So in trade-off, I would not be surprised if we see Darkseer come straight up. And then, well, the world is your oyster. The world is really your oyster as far as the hero you want to be selecting after this point. But Darkseer, the obvious one, whenever you're going up against something like a Naga Siren, you want to have a big, powerful-ass hero that can control team fights backwards. That's the whole thing. That's the thing you're searching for right there. Rubik will be the selection, I suppose. There is control of a team fight. It's a telekinesis into an AoE stun. Feybolt will remove a little of the damage as well, so there are good options from the Rubik. Maybe a Naga and Snare to steal, but you won't be looking for that. You'll be looking for some other bigger ability that will be coming later on in the lineup here by Strangby. But giving him some high priority here to pick up the Rubik. You can still take Core as well as one support. There's no problem with that.
10 seconds remaining.
So Twister, is he really going to pass up? He does! God damn it. Weaver selection. Kind of wish this hero would get out of the meta sometime soon. Weaver, he's here. But in the European so far tonight, he at least has the good start he was searching for. Really good damage once that Desolator comes up. You're already running around with that Lincoln Sphere as well. Because it seems like most teams seem like be happy to give the space to the Weaver. Remaining. There's so many other different combinations, though, which can punish the Weaver. And punish him really strongly as well. Chen and Naga. So now, yeah, Strangby does the wisest thing you can do whenever there is a Weaver on the field, and that is a proper push strat. That's what you've got to do. I want to see DK out with this lineup as well from 4FC, and I wouldn't also mind seeing the Alchemist.
10 seconds.
And I know with all that, yeah, you still get your straight-up stun up against the Weaver, but you get the Alchemist, Acid Spray down, Concoction's going to be there, no one's going to come in close to you, and he just destroyed tower after tower after tower after tower after tower. That's what they're in search for. Or what I hope they're in search for. Lone Druid could also come up into this mix-up, that way you get the possibility of the Entangle over on the Weaver. And with the Lifestealer banned out, yep, Twister thought it exactly as well. Like, you banned Lifestealer, I know exactly what you're thinking. So you remove out the Lone Druid. There's no need to ban out any other supports. Like, you're not going to be looking at a Lashrak because that will be a support Naga Siren. So DK for me will be the second one to be banned out here. If I'm going to be a gambling man,
5 seconds.
That would be what I would go with. Queen of Pain be the ban out by Strangby. So thinks about other kind of combinations. Do we see that Templar Assassin come back again to the middle lane? We saw the crits that it's capable of doing earlier on, but then again, we also saw the mistress. I was about to say the master, but she's a woman. The mistress of crit, which is the Phantom Assassin.
5 seconds remaining.
And Valera. Well.
Reserve time.
What are you going to give us, Twister? What are you going to give us? Are you thinking the same thing I'm thinking about the whole DK kind of thing? Or is this more of a other problem, because it could just be, oh, he takes out the Elder Titan.
Dire team pick.
It would have been possible. Like, it's always possible to run an Elder Titan. Would have been very frustrating as well to run up against it, but we haven't seen 4FC even hint that they would even think about such a, like, an unconventional pickup. Everything we've seen tonight has been so conventional, it's not funny. Nyx Assassin, Rubik up from Team 1. So they're building a fighting lineup very early on. They've already got the Rubik's Feybolt, which will pull the creep way back past the tower. And then Nyx Assassin. Good stuns if they can give him some space as well. Get that Vendetta up and running. He can hunt the Naga Siren before she gets to sleep off. V Vendetta hit straight to stun, or maybe even just start with a stun would be a way to go.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
So Chen will be here, and Naga. How do they want to combine this? It should just be Alchemist. It's such an obvious pickup for me. Like the Alchemist DK, then offlaner. But with the offlaner too, like Bounty Hunter would also be a really nice selection at this point. You got two Invis heroes which are going to be running themselves around. You want to have some kind of way to hold them off. And yeah, there we go. Bounty Hunter comes up. It's another hero of Krillies, which is the reason why it flags in my mind as far as the Bounty Hunter being a good selection. He works nicely in the game, and 4FC are comfortable with the Bounty Hunter. All Swedish teams are. Maybe not all of them. The top two Swedish teams, which are 4FC as well as the Alliance, they love the Bounty Hunter. So he'll come their way. He'll be the scouting man and the initiation. At the same time, he's got to be careful about what he gives over to the Rubik, because that can go the other way around. You let off your track, Rubik steals your track. All of a sudden, life is just a little bit harder as a Bounty Hunter. Not to mention Chen and everybody else who then is fighting up against an opposition with this high movement speed. But now Twist's going to make his mind up for his other lanes. Puck is still going to be one of those big ones to look at, but maybe a little bit concerned. We get the Darks here at least, so hey, we get our offlane hero. They got ignored through the first set. But yeah, that's also a nice hero to have with an Ix Assassin. Vendetta with an Iron Shield on top of you. You do a lot of damage once you come in. Like Vendetta, the Iron Shield burn, and the stun, it just destroys any hero you find. So even if Naga Siren stops to cast off her sleep, she can find herself burned to death before she can walk away, because she has to do an animation to cast asleep. And then follow up with a movement away. You could take a lot of damage in that time.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
So now Strangby. See what his fourth going to be. See how close I get with the prediction. I did that prediction after I saw the Chen. So we'll see how close we get. And we're going to go Puck. So what I thought might come the way of Team 1. In fact, comes the way of 4FC. The Templar Assassin is still in the pool, but it will not survive the banning stage. It will be banned out up against the Puck, or else one will just take it. Medusa? The last ban out here? I know a couple of teams were playing around with it, but it was the Elder Titan Medusa combo together. I remember Capitalist was talking about this the other night. I would say, together, you just can't push in. It's just not doable. So in this scenario, they get a ban at Medusa, an OD with a ban out here by Strangby, which means, I suppose, because you got both the counters to the Puck. You got both the OD and the Templar Assassin still in the pool. Yeah, Strangby still wanted to go down the lines of having the Puck. If he went the OD, and they go the DK. What is this crap? So stupid. Alchemist could still happen and just say it was blocked by the DK. they switch over the heroes I thought they were going to go. But now we've got counter push and a lot of droves. We've got team fight and we've got tower push out from one. And then they got the late game DPS as well, which will destroy all four of those heroes of 4FC. Even if Bounty has a BKB and walking around with his four-man shield, Weaver will still cut him to shreds once that Desolator is up and running. And DK will do the same kind of thing. A vac into a big Frost Dragon, you can lose your entire lineup at any point. One's lineup is really good right now. And Strangby, he needs the deeps. It's his last big damaging hero. Needs to get through DK, needs to get through Weaver. They have silences available. Decent amount of stuns. Not a straight-up stun. We've still got the Ensnare, which is projectile stun. You've got Chen, who will have Trolls, which will be projectile stun. Same thing, basically. Bounty on a projectile stun. And then Silence from Puck, which is a positional kind of thing, and it's Silence, so not a stun. So I don't know if he'll try and go another one, or just go all projectile stuns. we do get our Alchemist at the end.
Anti-mage.
And they say no. They say no fun. They say farm it. Screw this push strat that we thought we're going to get with the Chen. We're going to go semi-ganking. We're going to try and win our lanes early on. And if all else fails, The anti-mage will help us to succeed. That is the hope. That is the hope.
Prepare for battle.
All right. So let's get ourselves into it. We'll run through our lineup. So Twister, the next assassin heading down south. Looks like he's going to be combining up here with the Darkseer, at least to plant down the wards to start with. Also, in fact, no, everyone's heading down here. Dragonite's on his way down. Rubik's on his way down. And Gordon right behind him. He's built for some early Wraith Band as well as into Ring of Aquila. And it looks like they want to try and take a five-man fight down the bottom lane for 4FC. Strangby will be the anti-mage. Middle lane solo, Blomberg. Up towards the top, we'll have Boomski come in for the Chen. As the Chen, Cruelly up on the top lane, and that leaves our last end in Jussie. So 4FC back to their full roster, or at least their full roster with the normal stand-in they use. We're going to get Dragon Scale. We've got a Dragon Knight on here, so we'll go Dragon Scale. And they group up. Block Ward, and then search for an opening. And Jussie saw it. Jussie saw a lot of them on this bottom lane. And the line's being drawn out here, saying they're actually, is that from Weaver? I think they came out from Weaver, saying they're coming in towards the middle lane. It's like, screw it. Jussie's moving up. Boomski wants to try and control up his own jungle, and right now Gordon's just going to battle for the top rune, and the top rune doesn't spawn there. Some bottom, and it's a DD rune for the Darkseer. Nice thing to have if you're going to start creep skipping. Even nice thing to have if you're going to try and harass down the Naga Siren. Cruelly will wait for Gordon to walk up to the hill. But I have to body block up this camp. Didn't bring a ward with him, so he just jumps invis. So Bounty will be the long lane up against what will be a defensive tri lane out from one. And now Strangby. Bottom lane player up against a double iron shell. Screw this. Screw this. This is like the worst possible thing that could happen for an anti-mage. That sentry ward as well from Nyx. If he plants that just over the side here, the vision is pretty limited, but anytime there's a movement in or out, you're going to be seeing that. Cruelly again goes for the body block, but then you see what Twister does. It's like, well, you want to body block that one. I'm going to double stack this side camp, and then it's just going to be a pull over to this direction. Or if Darkseer wants to come back, like, okay, maybe that's what this is all about. Like, there's now a double stack on the easy camp. There was a double stack on the hard camp. But when Mitch comes back, he'll have a double, he'll have a double stack to farm up. Cruelly can't farm this up or contest it. So Darkseer gets really quick farm because of the extra work was being done by the supports. I like it. I like it a lot. So annoys the anti-mage, burns the consumables down a lot. And then just goes back after that. And that puts now Gordon in front as that Weaver. He's got a lot more farm up on him. And Fly wishes to say that DK is insanely good up against Puck. I can go with that, man. I can go with that. It is one of those things where you look at the burst damage. Like, Puck's harassment damage is normally negated by the fact you've got this Dragon Blood. And avoiding the breed fire is so difficult with the phase shift as well. So it all works together. I just thought TA or OD, man. Also very, very good. And they're the ones I would have been expecting more than a DK. But it's nice. And it works nicely with one's combination. And now, sentries dropped. Cruelly. Yeah, he's going to move back in range of it. Telekinesis pick up? Nope, they don't want to reveal the fact that there's a sentry down. They may get unlucky and their dire creep wave will do it for them anyway. Grazina has that bottle finally coming out to win the middle lane. While bottle has already arrived for the puck. DK will just pop off his salve beforehand. No 2-minute rune on the field just yet. And now Twister. Okay, so they see him go invis and they thought about just going blind stun. Okay, so DK is the head-to-head. That's fine. That's fine. I still like to say, okay, here's a comparison for you, Mr. Statman. Who has a higher win ratio? Oh, Cruelly! He is so... No! He's out of range again! For a second, he came in range of that sentry ward as he walked out, but Loke couldn't get the pickup and throw him back. Here's... Mitch, that's the farm we're talking about. Straight to the iron shell and just monies. While smoke moving by Boomski as well as Juicy. They're looking towards the middle lane. And see if they can catch out Grazine. And it looks like they will. Grazine's out just a little bit too far. There's already one. Ensnare, Troll Trap, Orb up. Damage to the Grazine, more than enough. First blood goes the way of 4FC. Good start for them. Now Dust on the top lane. Stun to go on Krilly. Gordon's on his way down, and Krilly walks into the army of both the Centaurs as well as the Hellbears. So he'll lose his life on the top lane. So first blood, 4FC. They could have lost it to one on that top lane, but they managed to snap it out in the mid lane first. Yeah, but my challenge to Mr. Statman, who has the better win ratio in the middle lane? Up against a puck, is it a DK, is it a TA, or is it an OD? There you go, your big challenge, Mr. Statman. Looks like Lowe's getting ready for a pull through. More, as much experience, as much denial of these creep waves as possible is what they're searching for. And Gordon, they gotta know that sentry wall is down now. Krilly, he's just walking slightly out of range of it. He's close enough to get a little bit of experience from this. And there goes your pull through. So he's gonna lose the entire dire creep wave worth of experience from this. And now, Krilly, maybe he doesn't know that's there. The stun will connect, a lot of damage, and they're gonna throw a dust just in case he walked out of range, which he did. But Weaver will get the last hit in. So this time he's the one, he's getting the kill as opposed to Nyx Assassin. And then on bottom lane, we've got Mitch as this Darkseer causing all sorts of problems. 24 for 0 for him as opposed to 1 for 0 his opposite offlaner. And Grazine with the dragon. He just wanted this tower to tick down. That's why he threw in that last hit. He can probably get himself in closer again. There was an iron shell left over by the Darkseer in that middle lane. In fact, it would have pushed in so hard that Grazine would be able to have a little bit more time to attack on that tower. But I think at the same time, Grazine wants it to push back his way. Might have to hold it on this line, but not for him to do that. Then he'll be in a position where Krilly could attack him. So yeah, he'll take the damage, keep it out of range of the tower. Bottom lane, there's a little surge away. Animage does have that mana voice. He'll be a little bit more careful. Then again, with the Iron Shield damage and the tower damage, has to blink himself away to safety. Alright, so boots of speed coming down for Grazine, so at least he'll move a little bit faster, but as far as the foot race goes, when you get yourself a haste rune, well, Blomberg will win it anyway. He's running around with orbs, he can just jump.
Denied.
Gordon. Still a good space up for him on that top lane. 23 denies. I'm on a bounty hunter, only level 3.5. Even when he's in range of the creep wave, there's so many denies coming out from one. Strangby. That should be his treads up and running if he's going to jump to that one. And will he? I think he's tossing it up. If he goes straight into Battle Fury, not. There's smoke movement by 4FC. And Mitch, well, he'll see it. And then instantly back up. And Snare will still manage to connect. Krilly's right behind it as well. There's an iron shell that's down, so some extra damage to Grazine. And look for that stun, he has that mana for it. The orb's off to the side, so now Dream Coil could have been used as well. But Mitch will bottle up, turn himself around. The courier's flying in some extra supplies as well as the bottle for the DK. Finally, the puck ulti will trigger on the Darkseer. And he walks himself away, but the dust will go, and they see Krilly. Nyx Assassin, good spy Carapace, buys the extra space, but the DK's still going to go down this one. Blomberg wants to keep fighting while Gordon searches for more kills. Gonna find the 10 in the corner. Fae Bolt from the Rubik ensures the last hit. As opposed to the possibility being denied up to the Satyrs.
Dyer's bottom tower is
and Blomberg, where's he running? There's your Iron Shell again on Strangby in the creep wave. Keep trying to push that one up against what's a level 3 Iron Shell now. 5-3 on the board. One have the lead, but by as smallest of margins. 500 gold and minimal experience. For an 8-minute game, it is most definitely negligible. They're getting key items up as well. So treads for Puck, but not near a Blink Dagger, but still running with a full wand as well as an old Talisman. Animage just had that 1,500 gold, so he could buy up a Claymore if he so desires. Oh, here we go. Head-to-head stats. DK 58%, TA 50%, and 49% in the OT. Waka, waka, waka. So the worst stats. The worst stats. Hey, wait, is that 58%? So DK has the best stats up. Oh, no. That was head-to-head stats. The puck would win. Yep. So OD. OD has the best stats out of the three up against the puck. And puck has the worst stats up against the OD. That's the way it works. Nice little play there, Nyx. Spy Carapace, maybe not required. Pick up, throw down. Where be these iron shells? They don't be coming. In fact, they'd just be Jussi keeping himself down the bottom lane. While Krilly tries to come in close to Gordon. And Gordon, oh, tell me you're doing it, Gordon. Tell me you're doing it. Tell me you're going BKB first. I want to hear these words, Gordon. Unfortunately, the words have to come out of my... Oh, other way around. DK is the biggest advantage versus Puck. What? Really? Oh, okay. I take it back. I take it back.
No money for you.
So DK is the best matchup up against the Puck. That's something we learn every single day. That's the reason why we bring in stats, man. Never really think of DK as the better counter. Moving on for that 10-minute rune. Going to spawn top. And we'll be controlled up by Blomberg. At this rate, as far as that mid-matchup goes, it is even Stevens. The only difference is going to be those extra denies, but it's like 8 extra denies up against a melee hero. It's basically nothing. Darkseid's in trouble. Darkseid's in a lot of trouble. Troll Trap pulls down the Iron Shell. Telekinesis pick up and throw down, so he's going to stun up Booms. He allows him to surge, but now Naga. Ensnare, Blink Up, Mana Void, worth it because it's a splash damage to Rubick. The Darkseid should have run up the right, not up the left. The salve has to come off from Rubick now to heal back up again. Well, Gordon looks like he managed to force that bounty off the top lane. More and more farm. 2100 now up for the Weaver. With Treads and the Ring of Aquila. What's he going to get from the side shop? Don't be a Ring of Health. Yeah, it's going to be a Manta style. We're not going to go BKB. We're going to go Manta. So he's going to break off the track with the Manta instead. Or possibly Silence. And have his freedom again. But a quick Manta going to be coming.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
The really sad thing is, too, with half of the stats which are flashed up... What the hell? Excuse me, keyboard. Go back up again. with half the stats which get flashed up, I can't even get to read them. You try watching minimap while trying to read text on the top right-hand corner where it's that small and, yeah. Trying to focus on everything else you're saying. Not a fun time. Denial of tower, not gonna happen. Nyx is down here. Oh, we got ensnared. At the same time, he got surged up. He's still gonna get in range for the stun over on the Chen. And Naga, whoa. Boomski was still burning a little bit from that iron shot, and they're gonna turn on this one. Telekinesis is still available. Needs some extra vision, however. Pick up on the enemy, throw him down. Extra quick stun. Nyx Assassin over towards the Naga Siren with that sleep on cooldown. Now they have no escape mechanism, trying to fight this one off. While Nyx, he still hasn't gone down yet. The Dire's Courier gets sniped off out of all things by the. It's the first casualty of this. While Boomski's locked into a corner in the middle of the entire one lineup, Blombo's coming down as well. Dreamcall is available. He does not want to fight up against five players here. The creep wave gets pulled over by the Satter. So attacking the tier 1 tower directly is not as easy. They pop off the dust. Is it close enough? Yeah, the dust reached it. Iron Shell damage, and now Puck Orb. And just the right click damage was enough. Krilly is so low on life, but there's track over on the DK. That's why they have to surge up on the Weaver so he can get himself in range in time. Move up, move up, move up. Have a guess, have a guess, have a gander. And there he is! The gander is right! And there'll be a gaggle after. Blomberg on the run. Gordon again. Now the Dream Call, which was stolen, is returned to sender. Viricus. And Grazine attack that tower again. There we go. Ticking it down. Get rid of the aggro off his desires. Fortification will have to be used, but it may not be enough to save it. They still have a lot of support here. Ensnare on Grazine. Pidair got the last hit in the tower. Grazine was still in range for it anyway. So DK can now finish up both Treads as well as Urn. So he'll get a lot stronger as well. While Strambi just evacuated and went up towards the top lane. run back out again. Damn it, Gordon! I really didn't want to say the worst that you're going Lincoln Sphere and just going Ultimate Orb first. Like, why? Why do you do this to me, man? Like, I thought, no, you know what? Wouldn't go Yasha, wanted some extra life points, he could fight during the fight, but in the end, he wanted to go the Mana Style, and it's gonna be a Lincoln Sphere. It was mere optimism. It was mere optimism is the reason why I said what I said. So Lurk now, got a bit of a wander down. There's gonna be a Haste rune in the bottom lane. There's no bottle in the kit there for the DK, or for the Nyx. Just a bit Rubik to take it. Maybe he can get a pickup on this bottom lane. The Animage back behind the tier 1 tower. They are bringing extra support in while leaving the Weaver to his own devices on the top. Who now has the money for the recipe for the Lincoln Sphere and then just needs the Void Stone. So he's looking really good. And that Rubik is just on speed. A couple of Naga Eludes going to spot him out though. Bumps into him. Realized they're kind of not real anyway. But Blobberg, he is real. Vendetta hit. Who do they want? Is there Vision? Is there a gem? They ensnare, and now Vendetta hit. Double stun, even with that Dream Core going off, the track will go on the Rubik. So 1-1 trade at the best, but with Puck going down, also not the best. Spy Karpus returns the damage. Now DK winds up the Dragon Form. In comes the Darkseer, blocking up the Naga Siren. Now they can try and turn a fight. Krilly, he needs to get a track out. So they've got the movement speed to move around with this one, but they're back straight back in again. Darkseer gets the kill on the Naga Siren. Now they got the track on the Darkseer. So two track kills. Going the way here of 4FC, at the same time that one just bought back their Rubik. He came in to defend this middle tower, doesn't get the denial, Chen was solo pushing this out. While in the top lane, Gordon does take that top tower. He's coming in for more. Chen, he'll hit on the Wild Wing, but Gordon, does he have enough damage for this? Is it, okay, no. Attack the Wild Wing on the way out. No, didn't have a chance for it. Razine now with the Shadow Amulet. He gets the items which we're talking about before. Gonna go with the Drums and the Urn. Both flying on the Courier at the same time. We're gonna go into a Shadow Blade as well. They see the Naga. DK, he's not in range form anymore, so he doesn't have the stun, but with the Breathe Fire, he's got a lot. And Gordon, just Shikuchi's up. It was already done before that Silence as well as the Dream Call was used. And now Illusionary Orb comes the way of Rubies. Now he's got a double nuke up his sleeve. Combining up with the 4 points up in that dual breath on the breathe fire coming out from the DK. Nyx. Vendetta's off cooldown, so time to hunt again. Hey, whoops! Takes aggro from the creep wave. Thought maybe there was an observer ward on the other side because he did take that aggro. It was just because he threw down the ward. Got a little bit closer. Yeah, there's no observer ward there. Regeneration rune in for the Weaver, who now does have the full Lincoln Sphere. And for one guy in the chat that asked me why I hate the Lincoln Sphere, it's bloody obvious. It takes forever to get. And there's minimal damage that can be dealt in the meantime. Where you want action style play.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Top lane, there's trouble. Or just that right click damage. Mech's not fully finished yet. Got pretty damn close to it. Just gotta finish up the buckler. Flies up the branch and just wants to run away. Krilly is right behind him while the bottom tower goes down. Nyx commits heavily. Three smokes all being purchased up there by the Nyx. It's not as though he's got enough invis as it is. He's going to give it to the rest of his teammates. Track up. They see the extra TPs coming in. And now, whoop, jump over. Twisted dead almost instantly. And now DK's also in the fight. He got stunned up. He turns it over towards the DK. Back in. Got a good copy in that wall. It's one of the Animage. But that also got burnt off very quickly too. Krilly picked up. He's just out of range to the Naga. Throws the sleep off. Slowing everything down. There's a TP coming. They're still on max range. There's no. There's no vac. Not enough time to get in range for a telekinesis. Which was already used when they started up on that top lane. That's when the Naga ulti was triggered. Krilly still searching for a pickoff. I don't know if he can really solo up the Rubik. Rubik's still walking around with that orb. Rubik can do a lot of damage himself. But a gem is definitely a priority right now for one. But at the same time, they don't want to do that. They have a Nyx and a Weaver. But this bounty is causing him such issues. He's gonna swipe it? Nope. Could have been a pain in the ass if he did so. There's that Desolator coming out for Gordon. On the way, at least. First Mithril Hammer down. Only one more to go on a recipe. They don't really have a... Like, they got some decent DPS. But they also need survivability. And the DK has got that. That's as long as he's the one that keeps the aggro. I suppose so does the Darkseer. They've also got the mech here. So if times gets rough, and if this is contested, they will have the mech for the fight. And with the Naga Sleep down, this is their best opportunity for this. And Nyx... Oh, whoa! Spy Carapace, a little bit of time, but 10 nukes him down after it's all gone. The Centaur went to work. So they're down a Nyx Assassin. And now the Naga Illusions come in. They see Roshan at low life. Park Orbit as well. Having a looky-looky. And Nyx back in 10 seconds. But really, that was a fight that Twisted didn't need to go out looking for. He wanted to have a scout, but you had to be aware that there was going to be sentry wards down there at one point. Like, you had observers and sentries down for the Radiant side. They dropped them both, and they dropped a deeper one as well. Are they coming in? Thinking about it. Radiant Vision will now see him now that Wild Wind gets in deep. And Twisted just needs a moment. He's lagging up. 200 MS. Is that the reason why you went in deep before, Twister? DK may be a little bit still annoyed that courier's on the sidelines. The one walking around with the Smoke of Deceit. Because that's meant to be bringing out his Shadow Blade, which he's already managed to fix up. All right, we're good to go. So one pours it up. Naga's sleep. Still on cooldown for another 50 seconds time. They just want to clean up this Wild Wind so they have easy access to kill off Roshan if they desire it. Also making him think about it. The tier 1 tower's already gone. That creep we're pushing into the tier 2 tower is not going to help out either. And Krilly. Now a DD rune under his sleeve. Was that Dire Observer Ward reach down that far? Oh, that would have had it just been on the edge. They should have seen him with it walking out of there, though. Strambi's going to be giving this up. He's got his Battle Fury and already wants to push out the top lane. He doesn't need to be involved in this fight. T1 Tower's more important. Krilly's coming up as well, waiting for that TP supporter to come in. Now the Skeleton Minions look at Roshan. And one, they've got to finish this. They've committed so much to this now, they've got to finish the job. And with Animage as well as Bounty Hunter on the wrong side of the map, they can do this. Maybe, well, then again, Naga's got sleep. The Chen Army's on the way in. The Naga Illusions are on the way in too. If they time this right, either they can steal Roshan, or at best, deny the Aegis. The Trolls are being picked up and thrown away. Now the rest of the support's coming from the top lane. And they initiate on Blomberg. A little bit higher up. Track now over on Twister. There's three heroes fighting up against Twister, and there's your Naga sleep. Jump in by Strambi, he drops his shield, he'll kill off Roshan, he takes the Aegis of the Immortal, and one are made to look like fools under here. Centaur Stomp gets two of them, the Mana Burn does little to nothing, and whoa! The wall and the Iron Shell! Gordon to the Shikuchi as well! Make them look like noobs and then turn it around here! The blink away, Rubik stole the Animage's blink. They're chasing after Krilly, the attack will follow him up a little bit higher, and he comes back down again, invis or not. Grazine, he uses his dragon senses and picks up the bounty hunter, and that was a huge save, an absolutely huge save coming out from Mitch. I was here to write that game off right then. It was so bloody obvious what was going to happen with the Animage, and at the end of the day, Mitch, like, they're all Centaur stomped up, and then that one wall and back into the clusterbuck. Shikuchi did its damage as well. The Iron Shell did its work. It was wonderful. Wonderful combination from the Darkseer. And that just saved them the fight. It could have been a lot worse than what's showing up on the graph right now, because that's also Roshan being taken into the equation on that. 1,000 gold and 1,000 experience advantage. 20 minutes in. Or 22 minutes in. Nothing. Again, still negligible. And Weaver, the fact he survived through that, is the highest CS, the highest net worth. He will be getting Like, he's 4-0 on this Weaver. This Desolator is on the way. DK has the Shadow Blade now. Nation. Nyx Assassin trying to return the damage on Blomberg, but he phase shifted it out. And Naga Siren. At least we'll have Arcane Boost, but that ultimate. Her timing was right. Everything was right, apart from everyone moving in at the end. They thought they were great. They thought they were golden. And then they got destroyed. And DK will come down to defend this bottom lane. Just a fake anti-mage, but still annoying enough that it burns off the mana. Yeah, drops him down a little bit too far. And Krozine's going to know this is something he has to do something about. But then again, AC, another way of approaching it. And Gordon goes into his farm. Full Desolator now done. Damage galore will fly. Anti-mage at least on his way to the mana style. I say on his way. Camps don't exist, so middle lane, now he'll have his mana. Then top lane movement by Crowley. We'll see Gordon up here. Obviously can't track him and get the instant detection. In fact, now Gordon says, well, okay. Well, I can still attack you and do some damage. But didn't just instantly come out of Shikuchi. And Krilly, again, moving around. And you can time-lapse out the track as well. They don't have the stuns and every other bit of controller. And Puck doesn't have enough mana to try and fight this either. So Gordon just hides underneath the tower. So, okay, so he uses to start with the Shuri toss, and then uses the track. So at least now he knows what's going on with Gordon. And Gordon, he's waited too long that he can't time-lapse out this track. Middle lane TPs are coming in to defend up against the Naga Illusions as well as more. While on the top lane, Iron Shell up on the Weaver. Still tracked, but definitely moving fast up against Boomsby. Look at that, look like, someone's just like cracking that mule. Get him away. That track movement speed. Just to at least snipe out the regeneration room. But Twister right behind him. Rubick there as well. Naga throws the sleep out. They throw down Central. Was like, how did you know? And the funny thing is, he didn't. Unless there's a... No, it's a gem. He had a gem. I take it back. He knows. He knows all. I just threw down the Sentry Ward anyway. Maybe just a D ward. Run down the middle. So all five heroes coming in from one. We've got Flame Dragon now up as well. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Strampy's going to take a tier 2 tower here. So this is just tower trade. Fortification had to be used by the Dire side as well. The only difference is with one with their full lineup here, they could push into the tier 3 tower. Are they going to try and defend? First one in is the DK, but he's too slow. No quick stun. And now they know the DK is out, they're going to look for kills. Krilly. Track over on the Nyx Assassin. Same with the Darkseer, but Darkseer, he's got Vakken Wall still. And now Blomberg, you got a silence up. It's only on the Nyx Assassin, stolen by the Rubick. Return as well. Grazine, back into the fight. Look at that damage onto the Puck. Again, the wall. Weaver now to pick up the Bounty Hunter. And we'll move over to Boomski. Shikuchi down. Remember, there's high level of damage. Combining it with the Iron Shell burn. Just attack him. And there goes your Genmin attack. Has to use both the Meg. He already used the Hand of God to try and keep his teammates alive. That's not going to help. Anti-mage bails as well. And now they can look to do some damage to this tier 3 tower in the mid. Bring down that one Dire Creep. Are they going in again? They're already inside. They're attacking the tower. They've got the negative armor on it. They kill off the creep wave. They want to do this quickly before Anti-mage can get back. Or before Puck respawns back up again. Even without the DK Dragon form, they don't need it. That's the power of the Desolator this early on. You can just destroy off Raxus, and that's the melee gone. They can take the range while they're here as well, because Anti-Mage still doesn't come back fully. And they're also in a position where they probably won't want to take a fight because they don't have all the Darkseer. Well, okay, double Sentry Ward is not required. Naga still got gem, doesn't she? Yeah, she does. So they're going to get rid of the wards anyway. But they don't have a Darkseer wall. They just back up. They took the Rax. Advantage to one.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Kind of like just like before. They take a mid-Rax, they back themselves up, and now they consolidate. But at the same time, they should really be looking to fight harder soon. And I'm kind of hoping that... Well, I don't know if Dias here doesn't really need a Blink Dagger. Mitch hasn't really found himself in a position where he would say that he hasn't been able to get a good wall off. for us to keep running into him, because they've still got two melee heroes and a Puck that has to jump in to get the silence and Dream Coil. Doesn't always have to jump in for the Dream Coil, but has to jump in for the silence at least. So maybe he's considering getting an Aghanim Scepter at this point of the game. The option. It'll all depend if this courier picks up a point booster on the way past. We've already got the start of the AC, the two big expensive items for Grazine. Obviously, he's still going to pick up that recipe, also bloody expensive. And Cruelly on the bottom lane. Oh, he smoked up. Grazine caught a glimpse of him. The pings came out from Nyx, that's why Grazine hid for a moment. They realize the bounty's down here, but Twister, don't be too aggressive. They're going to smoke up here. Cruelly's coming in first. Twister still sitting inside of his Vendetta, and now Animage gets triggered. He's like, where are they? Cruelly gets triggered as well, and they're all in close. They start up on Strambi, Spy, Carapace, Blomberg. They go on Grazine, and this is a fight that one did not want to take. Now everyone has to fall back to their tier 3 tower, because middle lane's pushing in. Someone has to defend here. 4 FC at this point, in any other situation, if they hadn't lost that mid racks, will be pressuring the base of one to force the buyback. But one, for some reason, has smoked. But they can defend easily. Even the Weaver. 4.3k gold now up on this Weaver. Cruelly came back to defend it up. Trying to get to his BKB. And the Naga illusions are left behind. Twister under the cover of the smoke. Maybe that's the reason why they keep on popping it. He did buy 3 of them a long time ago. Just move everywhere across the map under the cover of smoke. Twister got something else coming out in the courier. Sentry wards. Well, Gordon. Now 1,300 gold away from having his butterfly up and running. So then we have evasion. Well, Animage tries to build into a BKB. He won't be able to directly attack onto that Weaver. Same with the Bounty Hunter. Yep, there's the full BKB up and running, but BKB, it doesn't matter. Darkseer Wall is the one thing that's now not going to be as a bigger issue to him, as in, like, getting near it, but if he gets copied before that, it doesn't really matter. And then you're going to have Gordon now, who's got evasion. He did buy the evasions. He came down here, so they've already got issues hitting him directly. And once he converts into butterfly, look for your next item. Their Weaver is their primary problem, and their items they're building up is dealing with the Darkseer, who isn't even going to go to an Aghanim's. He's going into the Recite the Vice with the ultimate orb. So add a Sheepstick to this. Animage, if he gets caught out, the BKB will never even get triggered. Same with the Mana Style. And even if the Mana Style gets triggered by that point, you've probably got 2 Iron Shells on the field.
Haste!
That was Animage's old stout shield. That was the one he dropped when they sniped out Roshan. And is one really going to attempt this again? Attack. They can do it quickly. But Darkseer, they want to keep their Rax advantage. So he comes up towards the top lane, gives a quick Iron Shell. Roshan's still going to spawn up in 2 seconds. In fact, that was only one. But the Naga Illusion is already in there looking for it. A little bit of dewarding that was being done in the middle. Butterfly fully done for the Weaver. He can solo up Roshan right now. Doesn't need help. But DK as well as Weaver together means they'll at least walk out of there with full life points. But Gordon doesn't want to do all the hard work and then just have... Okay. Hard work or not, that's a lot of damage. They're backing up. The orb's coming in from Puck. Sees Roshan is damaged. But they probably also know that Weaver could do that amount of damage in a very short amount of time. And that's... Weaver goes that way, Nyx goes that way. Cruelly's in close, Naga Illusion gives him the vision. They gotta get rid of these Naga Illusions just as much as they have to get rid of the real ones. And now smoke time by one. They'll come around the back. There's no vision of what they just did then as well. The orb will fly. Observers and sentries. They are really... Look at them loop. As far as they can go, Naga Illusion. I don't know if it might have caught a glimpse then. I think it caught a glimpse. Yeah, they're backing up and moving up to the high ground of their own. And Nyx will walk. Don't walk up there. The Iron Shell damage. Who do they get close enough to? The stun. It missed on the Chen. The heals will still be there. But at the same time, Rubick, that puck jump in was perfect. Stramu inside the BKB. The fact back in again. Got nothing real. And maybe, well, there's two on the sideline. DK's low on life too. Weaver, he's going to try and turn, try and fight this one. A lot of damage to Blomberg. Able to pick up that kill there. They're moving now to Krilly. Lincoln's Fear will trigger. They've got the vision on Krilly. No, they don't. Has to time-lapse out this damage to Weaver, which means Darkseer Mitch is just too far in. And Weaver can't get any kind of snipe-offs. That Naga illusion, it must have caught a glimpse of it. And the Darkseer wall for the first time from Mitch was not a good one. It was off target. And Animage will come in, and will he think about this? Maybe he won't. Because they still have to send somebody back. The bugs are flying in, they latch on Strangby. There's still that Naga illusion having some vision around. Darkseer will buy back into this. Crawley had to go back into defense. How's those tier 4 towers survived? The middle lane was pushed out far enough. But now they must claim Roshan. Gordon, finish what you started. Puck's not here. They've got no Hand of God. Naga Sleep is again available. Is it? Are we really going to go through this again? Nyx is on the front lines. Mech Charge has already popped off. There's no BKBs available, and they got to see in. Now the Naga, the sleep went. They finished the job. Roshan killed by the Dire. Weaver picks up the Aegis Immortal, and they just had a range of the Naga sleep. So Gordon can pick up the Animage, and Boomski caught up from the high ground. It's one disastrous fight followed by another, but just different opponents. 16 and 19 now on the board. Animage on the sidelines. He has buyback available. But they're still fighting up against the pressure which has been applied by the middle lane. And with an Aegis Immortal up on the Weaver, he doesn't have time to heal up everything. In fact, he's very, very low on mana. But they want to push in, at least force the buyback. If they can, take Rax. Because the creep wave's with them on the bottom lane. Bottom tower is under attack. And Animage is refusing to buy back. It's not on cooldown. He's got the money for it. And the damage is out. Now the buyback will come. But the tower's already taken the biggest point of damage. And Gordon, the ensnare, triggers the Lincoln Sphere. He's full life again. He's full life again. And now the jump in. Great silence up by the puck. Catching out a lot of one again. But the fact back in. This time the wall's a good one. But there's a lot of cleave damage. And Gordon, well, he had to time-lapse it out. But he picks up the Chen. Now he attacks over towards Blomberg as well. Maybe had to pick up Krilly, but they don't have the vision on him. They've got the bottom racks. And this does look like 4FC. Radiant's bottom barracks. It's not just one foot in the grave. They're hip deep in this grave. The Aegis Immortal never triggered. The two big cores for one stayed alive that time. And that was with a great initiation up by the puck. DK will now have an Assault Cuirass for the next fight. And we will have 3,500 gold to put into something like a Crystallis. And then rack up her damage. If you had rares bet on one, I gotta say, your rares are gonna be looking pretty damn good right now. There's that four stuff also. Not the full thing, but pretty damn close to it. If he takes both of these, then he'll have it. Same thing with Nyx Assassin. They're both building into these four stuffs. And how's our advantage looking overall? 1,000 experience. Okay, negligible, doesn't matter. Gold grass and experience grass don't mean anything from now on. There's double racks for one. The only thing that really means anything is buybacks and team execution when it comes to the fights. And that's what it's all about. I'm kind of wondering where that gem ended up. Is it still Naga? That's 4FC's gem. That's still 4FC's gem. Stun was up on the top lane before. On the bottom lane, Strangby. Trying to push out the lane, which already is gaining momentum. While Naga Siren tries to hold out the mid. Just a couple of Riptides. And all of one heading down the top lane. But Strangby, he wants this bottom lane. Is this really going to become base race? It's not something that one have to do. Is there a there's no fortification for the Radiant side. But they don't have a real strong creep wave coming with them. So the TP comes back by at least Mitch. So he'll throw up the Iron Shells. And that's enough to stop this. We might see Gordon still do some decent damage onto that top if he wants to, and he did buy the Crystallis. But this is something which one doesn't have to take a risk and go for a base trade. Mitch just pushed at the mid, pushed at the bottom. Strambi's still here, but he won't TV back until it's time to go. And they focus on the tower. Gorn's going to get himself up to the higher ground before they can bring this little sucker down. And Snare will go. They've still got Naga Sleep. Shuritas will fly, but they're a little bit too far away. Four staffed away, and now good silence. It stopped the sun out there by Twister, and with a double BKB, they'll focus down the DK. And then over towards the Nyx Assassin. Weaver's the primary one. If they lose him, they're in trouble. And now he can just turn around and try and fight this one, or can they? The Ghost Scepter lets Mitch live a little bit longer, and Gordon, there's your damage. He wants the extra crit. Look for the puck. Phase shift, it's available, has to use it to evade this. And Gordon back over towards the tower. They've got this AM illusion fighting for them from the Darkseer wall. They get rid of the tower, and they're backing up. It's a mana void in the hands of that Rubick. And now Weaver can buy up his full Daedalus. Okay, he's even going to find himself an Ancient Stack. They got the tower, that was the primary thing. All the other lanes just push out in the time while that was going on. Without the DK, without the Darkseer wall, they don't want to overextend themselves, because they do still give respect over the pushing power that 4FC can have. Even though it's not massive from that anti-mage, it's still decent. And the team fight is also very, very scary, as you just saw. They're able to disable up. Both the DK and that silence from Puck was really clutch. If that stun from Twister managed to get off, then 4FC would be, in fact, out of the EMS right now. They would have no way of surviving. Gordon, finish your damn Daedalus. Maybe he's wanting to have buyback. Aegis is reclaimed in 30 seconds time. He wants to die right now. In fact, Gordon should run directly into the one lineup and just let him kill him. Look at him walk in. Just attack. Don't go invis. Just kill off as many people as you possibly can here, Gordon. That's your plan. Be the bait. Grazine, he's got some space. They pick up the Chen. And now his heal. Gone out the window. Naga throws a sleep off. But Gordon was still just far enough away. He could pick up a double kill. Aegis has 6 seconds time with a bounty in the Chen on the sidelines. Their chances are not good. Blomberg's blinks on cooldown. The bugs are flying out trying to scout him out. But he orbs up to TP back. But right now, one don't care. They have the creep wave with them. The bottom creep wave is pushing a long way. The Juicy, he doesn't have enough damage. He can put it back. So this is just about top racks. This is just about top racks. And it looks like DK at this point is going to keep his good record up against the puck. Kind of on the back of this Weaver, however. Who now gets triggered up a lot. Just keep attacking, man. Find someone, time lapse out, Strambi jumped in on it, and then Weaver focuses him. It's not even the full Daedalus he's attacking with, but look at that damage towards Krilly. The wall goes down, but it's more of just a precautionary thing. The bounty is brought down by Gordon. It's 13 for 0, and now with a generated attack, it's not enough damage to get the kill, but they bring down the last Rax. And Weaver, do you remain flawless to the end? Nyx Assassin will go down as a triple kill for Gordon. 14-0-5 for him. And now, there's free gold. Free gold. Pick up your Daedalus. Looks for the puck. The orb back again. The gem's on the deck and Blombo's got no face shift. It's a rampage. And GG! 16-0-5 Weaver. What happens when you give Weaver space, and the reason why Weaver is still played. And the Lincoln Sphere was the right choice at the end of the day for this. 41 minutes in. One will take the victory. So they will get to match up against Fnatic tomorrow evening at 20 CEST. I'll see you then for that broadcast. For now though, coming up next, the rebroadcast is coming, and that'll be involving also the Nexon Sponsorship League, which happened earlier today. And then you'll have all of the RaidCall EMS One Group Stage A matches from today also being rebroadcast. So that's what's coming up for you tonight. So stay tuned on the live stream if you want to stay in for that one. For now though, this Tidecaster, it's going to have a bit of a break. I got to wake up early to pick up my visa so I can travel over to Kiev next week. So yeah, stay tuned peoples for the rebroadcast. But if you're not going to, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.